Hello friends and again a video. Well, in Corona times it goes on and on. I toast to myself with the beautiful weather. So, where we exactly? We had designed a spindle head and tried to mill a circuit board. A nice user gave me a hint that I should decouple the motor from the mount to reduce vibrations. Here is my solution. I use two sealing rings embedded in the bracket. This way I have much less vibrations and can also do without the air plugs. Many thanks to Friedrich Kege for the tip. Sadly, I had to find out that the XY axis had an extremely inaccuracy, so I had to find out what the reason for this was. For example, I moved the X axis in one direction and then 0.1 mm in the other direction. It took up to 3 repetitions until the slide had moved physically. Here you can see the test. First, I suspected the stepper motors and the drivers. It may be that they cannot resolve so accurately. A quick calculation shows that with 16 microsteps, the stepper motors need 80 steps for 1 mm, which is about 1/100 of a resolution. That is not the reason. So I took a closer look at my camera in the iPhone. Here is the result. The pulley, so the bed wheels turns and the toothed bed also. Only the carriage does not, as you can see on the dial gauge. In the end, it is due to elongation of the toothed belt and the lack of the stiffness of the frame. The whole thing is called backlash in the technical jargon. So what was my solution? I decided to throw away the timing belt and change my Hypercube to trapezoidal spindles. With such trapezoidal nuts with preload, it is possible to reduce the backlash to a minimum, but not quite. On this picture you can see the construction. Due to manufacturing tolerances, the nut wobbles a bit on the threaded rod. Here a video you can see that. That's about 1 to 2/10 of a millimeter if the motor turns the rod. It will first go this way without moving the nut. That's the backlash. The solution, the nut pressed over the springs a second nut against the flanks of the thread, and this bridges the backlash. The groove on the side prevents the small nut from turning with the rod, but this does not work on 100%, but more about this later. So let's get to my new design. Here is the design of the X axis. I designed the design so that we only have to change some parts to be able to change the to trapezoidal spindles. Here we have the trapezoidal spindle with a new slide that holds the nut. A NEMA 11 motor is embedded on the right side and connected to the trapezoidal spindle with a direct coupling. On the opposite side, we have a ball bearing that holds the spindle in the middle. A bracket for the motor provides a secure hold so that the motor cannot move. In the video here, you can see how the X axis works in real life. With the Y axis, it is even more simple. I have developed a new bracket for the backlash nut, which is screwed on the boss side. This holds a trapezoidal spindle, which is screwed to a pulley for the GT2 belt at the end. Now one could ask oneself, why again a toothed belt is used, which I wanted to prevent because of the elongation, etc. First of all, it is much shorter belt, so that the elongation is not as extreme as with the old Core XY design. Secondly, we can control the backlash better and compensate it better via firmware. The spindles are held by bearing blocks, source of supply, of course, like all other parts in the video description. These have a ball bearing. Here you should take care that they should be screwed under tension with a spindle. That means you bend the bearing blocks a little bit inwards, then screw the bearing to the spindle and then the bottom screws to the profile. It must not be possible to move the rod in the longitudinal direction, so simply try to move the rod in its direction. If it is, at least possible, check the bearing blocks again. Also here a video of the Y-axis. After everything was assembled, I noticed again a backlash of about 0.2 millimeter. So the backlash nuts do not work 100%. So I dealt with a Marlin firmware and could find a backlash compensation. Unfortunately, sadly, this is not available in my used version 1.19, but only in the new Marlin 2. So I went to the computer and got the part, merged all settings of my machine via branch and uploaded them. Of course, we have to switch off Coax Y in the configuration and adjust the steps per minute to the stepper. The backlash compensation can be set in the configuration. First, we activate the feature via backlash underscore compensation. Then we actually only need the G-code command M425, which we activated via backlash underscore G-code. How to use the whole thing? First, we determine our backslash in millimeter with a dial gauge. We move 1 millimeter in one direction and that's the same distance in the other direction. The difference is a backlash, which has to be compensated. Here I found a difference of 0.18 millimeter for the x-axis and 0.15 millimeter for the y. Of course, you should do several measurements and then take the average value. In the command M425, we define the values for each axis and F1 switch the compensation on. If you want to save the whole thing forever, just enter M500 and the values are saved in the EEPROM and are available immediately after connecting the machine. Let's test if this really works. In order not to have to mill immediately, I simply took a 0.1 mm diameter Staedtler pin and started the G-code to mill the circuit board. As you can see here, we have round circuits and not step losses. All STL files can be found in the video description, of course, also the links to buy the parts. So I hope for your comments and say goodbye until the next video. Greetings, your Frank. Sorry for my bad English. Subscribe my channel. Anyway, bye.